I think they did quite a good job in that the film is actually very heavy with CGI, most of the ape characters, but they still got a lot of character and personality, which I think a lot of other CGI full films kind of fall short on, and they're like kind of crappy
Yeah,
adaptive
what they did
story.
was
Lord of the
not.
Rings 3.
No. Not only that, they put a lot of effort into the CGI rather than what people do is like last minute, oh, we can't do this. Let's put a bunch of CGI and save the film. And they did concentrate a lot on the character. I mean, Caesar's been built up after all these years. He's like, the film is great as an individual, but it's great also as a part of the whole of the trilogy. Caesar's grown up and he's matured. He's very much a human character. And I think the part of the story is that once they get the intelligence, the apes are very much the human characters.
That's it. Due to the motion capture, like we can see emotions, and we can see the what the character wants to express. So, with Andy Serkis, he's used to this situation before. As he's mentioned, Lord of the Rings, Stardust Gollum or Sméagol, whatever you want to call him, they've used experienced actors.
Can I interrupt?
Yes, sir. Go ahead.
Perhaps the only good thing to come out of King Kong was that Andy Serkis was very well easily trained to be an ape.
That's it. And the CGI in this, it was on another level in the way that it wouldn't disturb the movie and the
It
actor.
blew me away. I was like, are these real apes or is this CGI? It was very, very hard to tell.
It's not like Green Lantern. And I have opinions about DC, but this is not the time. So,
we'll be doing that. We'll be doing that podcast a different
yeah,
time.
surely. So, yeah, if we get back to talking about War of the Planet of the Apes, War for the Planet of the Apes, sorry. Now we've talked about Caesar's character.
Can I just jump in one sec? You guys are talking about the CGI. My question is, how is it so different? Who did it? Did someone else? Did someone different to undertake this as compared to normal? Or who did?
They,
you know,
firstly,
what
it took it took them a long time to produce the film. So they did a couple of things. They did they had them wearing those suits, the video capture suits,
mm-hmm.
and they used it for their expressions as well. They used what appears to be a very, very good team. Thing with CGI is the thing with general filmmaking is what you put out, what you put in is what you put is what you get out. Effort very, very clearly shows whether it's CGI or practical effects. The more effort you put into CGI, the more you get out of it. It's film. That's filmmaking 101.
But
I
think it's not just that. If you look at this film or in most other films, CGI is used for like big special effect action
film. To make it easier, yeah.
But if you look at this film, they're using it for capturing like mundane monkeys walking around talking to each other. There's not, even though it's titled War for the Planet of the Apes, there's not that much action in the actual film. So I think that's another aspect of it to kind of show that CGI has multi-purpose.
Absolutely.
Like the CGI in this, we actually need the CGI to explode the
narrative. You have to have it.
Without the CGI, there'd be like monkeys in suits.